Welcome to a presentation on border area development between the Malaysian state of Sarawak and the Indonesian province of West Kalimantan on the alumina industry.
Aluminum is the most widely used non-ferrous metal in the world. It is characterized by its resistance to corrosion, its strength and hardness, and low density. Aluminum's main ore is bauxite, which contains 30 to 60% of aluminum oxide, commonly known as alumina, and a mixture of silica, various iron oxides, and titanium dioxide. Bauxite is refined through the so-called Berhad process to extract aluminum oxide. The aluminum oxide is in turn refined through a smelter process to produce aluminum metal. Aluminum smelters cannot be located near raw material suppliers since they involve an electrolytic process that uses large amounts of electricity and therefore tend to be located close to power sources. For that reason, raw materials for the industry are usually located in different geographic regions of the world. Bauxite and alumina reserves and mines are located in countries like Guinea, Australia, and Brazil, while the world's largest aluminum smelters are located in Russia, Canada, and India. Only Australia and China have smelters near their raw material sources. West Kalimantan is an important producer of bauxite and alumina. Those exports reached $126.8 million, and they were mainly directed to East Asia, namely Hong Kong, Japan, China, and Taiwan, as well as Latin American markets such as Mexico. There have been no exports to Malaysia, and in particular Sarawak, which has one of the world's largest smelter plants. West Kalimantan currently has a chemical-grade alumina plant with a capacity of 300,000 metric tons a year of alumina. PT Indonesia Chemical Alumina began operation in 2014 and is in Tayan Sangau Regency. Ownership and control is shared by Indonesian state-owned metal and mining company PT Aneka Tambang, also known as PT Antam. It has only 80% ownership of the company. And Showa Denko KK, which has 20% ownership. PT Antam also has bauxite mines in Tayan, where there exists Indonesia's largest bauxite reserve, estimated at nearly 116 million tons. A second alumina factory, also owned by PT Antam, will be completed in 2019 in Mempawa Regency. It will have a 1 million metric ton annual production capacity in the first of its two-stage development process. Its smelter-grade alumina refinery capacity will be capable of processing 6 million metric tons of bauxite ore a year. In Sarawak, pressed metal Berhad has three aluminum smelters. The Mukah-based smelter, which was constructed in 2007. Second, the smelter plant in Samalaju Industrial Park, Bintulu, which began operation in 2012 and has a production capacity of 320,000 metric tons a year. And third, a second phase smelter in Samalaju that was established in 2014. Sarawak's total smeltering capacity is currently 760,000 tons annually. Pressed metals operating capacity in Sarawak makes it the 12th largest aluminum producing company in the world. It produces primary and extrusion products and a variety of finished products such as aluminum ingots and billets, bronze color finish, fabrication, fluorocarbon, mill finish, natural anodized finish, and polishing and powder coatings. The following are the steps involved in aluminum production by PT Indonesia Chemical Alumina in Thailand. First, aluminum oxide is extracted from bauxite. Second, aluminum oxide must be purified before it can be refined into aluminum metal. The so-called Bayer process is the standard industrial method used to refine bauxite into aluminum oxide. Indonesia Chemical Alumina also produces aluminum hydroxide, which is used for the manufacture of other aluminum components. Those components include specialty calcined alumina, aluminum sulfate, polyaluminum chloride, aluminum chloride, zeolites, sodium aluminate, activated alumina, and aluminum nitrate. Aluminum hydroxide is used in fire retardants, pharmaceuticals, and other product applications. Pressed metal in Sarawak uses the Hall-Héroult process to convert aluminum oxide into aluminum metal. The aluminum oxide is poured into special reduction cells with molten cryolite. Electric currents are then induced into the mixture, and the current breaks the bond between the aluminum and the oxygen atoms. The process causes the liquid aluminum to settle at the bottom of the reduction cell. Primary aluminum is then cast into ingots and shipped to customers or used in the production of aluminum alloys for various purposes. Those aluminum alloys are then shaped into their required form to make aluminum products from mobile telephone bodies, airplane fuselages, and other applications. Given the high transportation costs of alumina, it would make economic sense for West Kalimantan to supply Sarawak's aluminum smelter plants. Alumina, or aluminum oxide, is a bulk commodity whose competitiveness is closely related to distance to market and transportation cost. The cost of transporting alumina from South America to the United States aluminum smelters, for example, represent about 15% of the total cost of producing aluminum. Our gravity model estimates for Sarawak alumina imports from all supplying countries to the state indicate that a 1% reduction in the distance to suppliers leads to a 1.4% increase in the quantity of alumina demanded by smelters. The increase is caused by the lower cost of CIF imports, which in turn translates into the ability of smelters to sell alumina at a more internationally competitive price. Distance to suppliers therefore plays a huge role in the success of smelters in Sarawak. Unfortunately, those smelters tend to enter into long-term agreements with foreign suppliers, and those arrangements become personal and long-lasting. There's less of a tendency to source supplies through competitive tendering processes like in Western countries. Because PT Indonesia Chemical Alumina in West Kalimantan, Thailand is in Sangau Regency, it is near the border with Sarawak. Also, there are new roads to the border and good CIQ infrastructure at Entikong. The resumption of trade between Sarawak and West Kalimantan offers new opportunities for cross-border exports of aluminum oxide to aluminum smelters. For details about the resumption of border trade, see our video on Sarawak-West Kalimantan border crossings in this channel. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel to keep up to date with industry-specific projects on cross-border value chains. If you enjoyed this video, give us a like